Hello YouTubers, so moving on from the last upload about the TRV45 here. Here is the TRV410 that I did a video I think on yesterday. Digital 8 unit, power model, 4 inch screen, not like the 4.5 on there, so that's got the bigger screen. This is a better camera, digital 8, showing clearly on this label. This is from 1999, this unit, so when digital 8 debuted. Clearly stating there you're recording on high 8 tapes, which was a great feature for people that had previously had video 8 and high 8 cameras because they could use their old tapes. This one has night shot as well. It's just done as a slide button, which I don't like as much, but it's there. It's still night shot. But yeah, as I was talking about in the last video, very unusually, this is a power camera. Normally, I've said many times, you'd look up cameras and there'd be a POW and then the American model would have less resolution, but it would have, generally speaking, but it would have the recording capability as this one has here to record via its Ferno inputs on the side. And then you could use this camera, be ideal for that, unlike that one where yes, you can record onto it. It doesn't have a firewire because it predates that. It's only video 8. So you can record onto that normal TV or something, you know, with Ferno wise, but you can't digitize it where this camera can. So these cameras go for more money, or any of the digital 8 cameras where they have a VCR capability, a lot more money generally, because you can use them to upload digitized VHS and all sorts, as well as obviously doing the older, playing back the video 8 and high 8 tapes and digitizing them again via firewire. Yes, this is a power model as a state, and if you look it up on eBay today, you should still see it if it's on there. If you look up today, there's two of these cameras, both POW. One has player written there rather than VTR, videotape recorder, and the other one has this. So I got lucky on this one. This has the color viewfinder as well. I think the other one did, as I remember looking at the listing. They're not in as good condition as this one, so I've got lucky here overall. Plus this has, again, the video capability of doing analog inputs to firewire outputs, so brilliant. But yeah, completely baffled and threw me off because I have the TRV110. I had it for the longest time, and I've seen the American version, which I think is called the 103. And I just assumed that camera is those two different model numbers, and that clearly means the POW can't do the recording of the inputs and the American one can, and that's the end of it basically. But here this camera shows clearly, and with the TRV110, type that in, there is two variants with the same model number. I'm just baffled. There must be something in it, but when I look up the manuals, you look this up now on Sony's website for the manual TRV410E, there's two manuals because there's two of the same models. Bizarre. But yes, let's have a look around it. Stereo microphone, of course. There's your firewire connection there. It's got a hot shoe on this camera as well, so that can power things like external microphones, lights and so on. Now you've got night shot, you could get additional IR blasters, I think that's what they're called, to make the night vision even more powerful. This one has laser link as well, which was ability to wirelessly send the video signals to a receiver that you could buy from Sony at the time. It's got a headphone socket, microphone input, Fernos as usual here. This will have S-Video as well, being a digital 8 model. I don't know if all of them had S-Video, but I would imagine they would have. Certainly, as far as I know, all of mine have. So normal stuff on the back, as you'd expect. Let's just open the screen. Sorry, doing this on my iPhone. Buttons inside. Door there for the CR2025 battery to hold memory and data settings, and so on. But yeah, that is the camera. But really, really nice model. Both of these are in mint condition. This one came with all those tapes I told you about when I did the upload from this camera. It came with a lot of these. Show you. These are. No. These are data cassettes, which were designed primarily, obviously, designed for computers, but for whatever reason, seems to be identical because they work in cameras absolutely fine. Now, saying that, if you have a higher camera and put one of these in, it will see it as a video 8 tape and you'll only get the backward compatibility mode. So for a Hayek point of view, these are not ideal. I've had Hayek cameras, which I think is when I first saw one of these and was like, what the heck is this? But you will not got that, you will not get the Hayek picture quality on it unless you probably can do something with the tabs, which was done with some of the other tapes. You could push one of these tabs in here and it would sort of trick the camera. But digital 8 is not picky. As long as the tape is good quality, it will record. So I can use these, the 30 or so I've got, which is crazy, which is a really good find, and put these in this camera and just use them as they already have been mostly used in this camera and get digital 8 into them. So yeah, really happy with those. Great find, and really happy with this camera in general. Just a great one for the collection, and with that input ability, it just makes it more usable for me, especially if I'm doing my own tapes, but customers as well. When I get the odd customer job come in to do some tape transfer, these are the sort of cameras that are what I need to do the job. But yeah, both of these in the last couple of days, 45. I haven't done the recording on that yet. Waiting for the battery to turn up for it, and I'll get some recording and upload that shortly. And probably get some low light night shot stuff outside as well. That'd be quite good. But yeah, you've already seen video from this. Very standard sort of digital 8 stuff. Nothing special on the picture quality, but certainly feature packed as a unit. Anyway, that's all for now. Bye for now.